get some great experiences. I was in Davenport, Iowa, and I found this old warehouse. It looked 1920s. I had a 1928 Indian motorcycle. There's pictures of it. And I got my tripod out, and I did this and that and the other, and got it all set up. And you know about parallax? When you're standing in the railroad tracks, you're this way.
Where are you going?
And you keep getting narrower and narrower, and you go out there and finish it. And I had all that. I took the pictures. I'm about ready to fold up shop. I see two little boys coming down the road. They're like 50 yards away. Like, one of them had a t-shirt, and they said, I'll get him to take his t-shirt off. Because they were going to like 1920s. They got as close as you are to me. And before I could say anything, one of the boys said, please, mister, may we be in your car? I kissed them. And they had a lot of pictures.
That's cool.
Anytime you capture something besides just a motorcycle, that's a good thing.
That's good.
Perfect.
I like because of what went into it. My friend in Australia, Melbourne, Australia, had a beautiful motorcycle I wanted to photograph. And I told him, well, he said, where do we want to photograph my motorcycle? Well, there's only two places that dumb Americans know about enough that they can say, ha, that's Ayers Rock, or ha, that's Sydney Opera House. And that's what I said. So he said, well, we'll go to those two places. Now, Ayers Rock in Melbourne is about like from Dallas to Portland or Seattle, Washington. It's about, it's over 1,500 miles. And so anyway, we're cruising along. And the car quit. We got a replacement car. I don't remember the details. And we're driving at 120 according to the speed limit, but that was kilometers, so it was like 90 or 95 or something like that. And this car starts shuddering. And the Australian that was driving me was working by the hour for my host, so he's like my personal slave. He takes me wherever I want to go. Car starts missing. He says, I think we're out of petrol. So, out of petrol. So we do this for a while, and a big truck will go by about every 15 minutes. None of them stop. Now if we urinate into the petrol tank, the urine being a little bit heavier than the water will sink to the bottom and raise the fuel up and up perhaps to the standby. Okay, so we do that, and I'm thinking, if somebody stops, please, I want to be in the group. And I didn't get my camera out because I have to get a picture of him, but anyway, we made love to the guest. The engine started. But we went about 20 yards, and it was it. And the town was like 3 miles away. You see the town. So finally a guy comes through, and he's got nothing in the back of his big truck except a bunch of these aluminum jerry cans for people to run out of gas. I don't know why they call them jerry cans. So we get there. I'm going to photograph this motorcycle because it's perfect and because it's worthy of such a sight. So I'll pass this around. You can all have a look at it. Another neat thing about that was there was a group of Europeans, I think most of them are French, and I'm right here with my camera.